So we looked at a study with CIBMTR in which we tried to see if, you know, the choice of triplet induction therapy matters. What we did was we selected patients from 2013 onwards who had either bortezomib, cyclophosphamide, dexamethasone or VCD induction, or bortezomib, lenalidomide and dexamethasone or VRD induction, and then underwent upfront transplant within 6 months, and they should have achieved at least a partial response. So really trying to compare the triplet induction regimen in transplant eligible patients undergoing upfront transplant. And what we found was that the response rate at very good partial response or better were very similar in the three arms, in the two arms. Now, there were some key differences between the two arms, as one would expect. In the VCD arm, more people were found to have renal dysfunction. Again, cyclophosphamide is commonly chosen over lenalidomide when patients present with renal dysfunction. So that's understandable. And people were also more likely to have light chain myeloma and high ISS stage. Again, these are driven, you know, light chain myeloma is associated more with renal dysfunction, and with renal dysfunction, beta 2 microglobulin goes up, and therefore ISS stage is higher. So, you know, there were some key differences in the two groups. But as I said, the response rates of very good partial response are better before transplant, after transplant, and as best response were similar. We then looked at survival analysis. And in survival analysis, we found that in univariate survival analysis, that patients undergoing VRD induction actually had better progression-free survival and overall survival. However, you know, there are several key confounding factors which also impact survival in myeloma, such as high-risk cytogenetics, ISS stage, and receipt of maintenance therapy. And once we adjusted for the key confounding variables, the choice of induction therapy no longer mattered. And maintenance therapy, you know, turned out to be a very important prognostic factor, more than most other, you know, prognostic factors in that model. And what we found was if patients got maintenance therapy, they did really well. And if they didn't, of course, they'd had poor outcomes. So in summary, you know, the choice of triplet bortezomib induction did not matter as much as the choice of maintenance, which was lenalidomide in most patients. And clearly, patients spend much longer in the maintenance phase, which is several months to years, compared to only 4 to 6 months in the induction phase. So those results, again, emphasize that it is the longer duration treatment that really matters in multiple myeloma.